Physics is an experimental science, and for experiments, we have to make measurements of physical quantities. Physical quantities like distance, force, etc. In mechanics, there are three fundamental quantities, and these fundamental quantities are length, usually given in units of meters, centimeters, foot, inch, and the second one is mass, and the mass is given in units of kilograms, grams, pounds, etc. And the third one is time, and the time is measured sometimes in seconds, sometimes in hours, ages, millennium, sometimes in milliseconds, etc. Other than fundamental quantities, we also have derived quantities, and these are, for example, area, force, velocity, etc. In addition to fundamental quantities, in mechanics we also have derived quantities. Derived quantities are the physical quantities which are derived from these three fundamental quantities. For example, area is expressed in terms of length square. Likewise, the volume is expressed in terms of length cube. And for example, force is nothing but kilogram meter per second square. We will see this in chapter 5. So in mechanics, there are three fundamental units: length, mass, and time. And we label the capital L to denote the length measurements. The capital M is for the mass measurements. And the capital time is used for the time measurements. In observations, sometimes we see that the length measurements are given in terms of centimeters, and sometimes we see the length measurements are done in terms of foot, and sometimes in terms of meter. In experiments, it is very important to continue with the same measurement system. For example, if you start the length measurements in terms of centimeters, then for all your length measurements should be done in centimeters. Similarly, if you start with foot, you continue by measuring all length measurements in terms of foot. So, since we have different units for the same measurements, we have to pick up some certain units for each fundamental quantities. For example, in CGS or Gaussian unit system, all length measurements are done in centimeters, all mass measurements are done in grams, and all time measurements are done in seconds. And in SI unit system or in MKS unit system, this is different. The length measurements are done in meters, and the mass measurements are done in kilograms, and the time measurements are done in seconds. So the choice of units determine the unit system that you are going to use. And in this class, in most of our problems and in experiments in the lab, we will use the SI unit system, in which we measure the lengths in meters, and measure the mass in kilograms, and measure the time in seconds. In physics, most of the time we are facing this problem of converting one physical quantity into another unit system. For example, you may be given a measured value of speed in terms of mile per hour, and you are asked to convert this same measurement into meter per second. So in this problem, what is 65 mile per hour is in terms of meter per seconds. So miles is a unit of length, and hour is a unit of time. So for this, we need to convert first miles into meters and hours into seconds. For such kind of conversions, what we need to find first is the conversion factor. So the conversion factor for each unit conversion. For example, in this problem we have two unit conversions. One is from miles to meters in length measurements, and the other conversion is from hours to seconds. Let's start with the length conversion factor, which converts miles to meters. And you are given that we know 1 mile is equal to 1609 meters. So the conversion factor for mile to meter conversion is nothing but 1 mile divided by 1609 meters, or 1609 meters divided by 1 miles. You have to make sure that these factors, these ratios, are nothing but equal to each other, and they are equal to 1, because 1 mile is equal to 1609 meters. That means this each ratio is equal to 1. But they serve differently. If you need to convert meters into miles, the first ratio need to be used. Okay, you have to use this first ratio if you want to convert meters into miles. But if you want to convert miles into meters, then you have to use this second ratio. So it is obvious that for this problem, since we are converting miles into meters, we have to use this second ratio, 1609 meters divided by 1 mile is our conversion factor. So the next conversion is between hours and seconds, and we all know that 1 hour is equal to 3600 seconds, because 1 hour is 60 minutes and each minute is 60 seconds. So it is very obvious that we have this conversion between hours and seconds. And then we are ready to form our conversion factor. Again, we have two conversion factors. One is used to convert from seconds to hours, and the other is used to convert from hours to seconds. So the first one, the first ratio is to be used for converting from seconds to hours, and this is 1 hour divided by 3600 seconds. And the second ratio, which is exactly equal to the first one because they are equal to each other, but this is to be used if you are converting from hours to seconds. Okay, now we are ready to convert this 65 miles per hour into a meter per second. So for this, the first thing to do is just we write down 65 miles divided by hours. We have to write down this ratio, because this is our original unit for the speed. And since miles in on the denominator in here, we have to use the conversion factor in which the miles are on the denominator. In order to get rid of these miles and left with meters, we have to use this conversion factor of 1609 meters divided by 1 mile. And it is very obvious, because we have to get rid of the miles and we are left with meters. So we have to use this second ratio, not this one. Okay, so it is very obvious to use this one, because we want to get rid of miles. And the mile that we are going to use in the conversion factor should be in denominator. So, and next, we have to multiply this number with the second conversion factor, which is responsible to converting from hours to seconds. But since hour is in denominator, then we have to use the conversion factor 1 hour divided by 36 seconds. Okay, so this conversion factor is the first one in here, 1 hour divided by 36 seconds. we are using this conversion, this first ratio, because we want to get rid of hours, and hours is in denominator in the original measurement. So to get rid of hours and just left with 1 hour second, we have to use this first ratio. Okay, so when we write down all these numbers, all we gotta do is just carry out the multiplication, and we, since miles are canceling out in here, and we are left with meters in here, and this hour cancels out this one here, and you are left with 1 hour second. So at, in the end, it is very obvious that we are left with meter per second, meter divided by second. And to get the result, it is very obvious that to we have to multiply 65 with 1609 and divide it by 3600. So if you carry out this multiplication, then you will find this 29 as the result, and this 29 meter per second is the 65 mile per hour in SI unit system, where we measure length in meters and we measure time in seconds.